little church and I worship there. Today, it made me think of the good old times before my hair was gray. The meeting house was finer built than they were years ago. But then I found when I went in, it was not built for show. The usher did not set me down away back by the door. He knew that I was old and deaf, and he saw that I was poor. He must have been a Christian man. He led me boldly through the long aisle of that crowded church, and he found me a pleasant pew. I wished you'd heard the singing, wife. It had the old-time ring. The preacher said with trumpet voice, "Let all the people sing." Old Coronation was the tune. The music upward rolled till I thought I heard the angel choir strike all the harps of gold. My deafness seemed to melt away. My spirit caught the fire. I joined my feeble, trembling voice with that melodious choir, and sang as in my youthful days, "Let angels prostrate fall, bring forth the royal diadem, and crown him Lord of all." I tell you, wife, it did me good to sing that old hymn once more. I felt like some wrecked mariner who gets a glimpse of shore. I almost want to lay aside this old weather-beaten form and anchor in the blessed port forever from the storm. 'Twas not a flowery sermon, wife, just simple gospel truth. It fitted humble men like me. It suited hopeful youth. To win immortal souls to Christ, the earnest preacher tried. He talked not of himself or creed, but Jesus crucified. Dear wife, the toil will soon be o'er. Our victory will soon be won. The shining land is just up ahead. Our race is nearly run. We're nearing Canaan's happy land, our home so bright and fair. Thank God we'll never sin again. There'll be no sorrow there. There'll be no sorrow there. In heaven above, where all is love, there'll be no sorrow.